Hi there, folks. I'm meteorologist Darby Bybee with your 4029tv.com forecast. You know, as we go into the weekend, we could be dealing with quite a bit of rain, and flash flooding could be an issue. We'll get to that in a second. Take a look at our satellite radar composite. You can see out there right now, as of our Friday evening, we've got redevelopment of thunderstorm activity across southeast Kansas. Some new development occurring now here in northwest Oklahoma and southwest Kansas. And these storms, they're going to make their way to the east and then to the southeast and to northwest Arkansas, I think, later on tonight. So if you plan on making it out to the Naturals game tonight in Springdale, they're taking on the Tulsa Drillers at 7 p.m. Of course, Jerry Springer's going to be there. Could see some rain problems, especially towards the end of the game, maybe some rain delays if you're headed to that game. Might want to have a plan B available. Now, flash flooding will be possible once again this weekend. The flash flood watch that the National Weather Service has posted, you can see all the counties shaded in green right here, including Benton and Washington counties in northwest Arkansas. This flash flood watch, it does go until 1 p.m. on Saturday. We're going to have flash flooding being a concern, I think, throughout the course of the weekend, but initially, at least, it's mainly tonight into Saturday morning that we're concerned, at least initially, with the possibility of flash flooding. Of course, that's going to be isolated. Wherever there is flash flooding, it's not going to be everywhere, just in isolated locations. But it's a concern as we go throughout mainly tonight. So a 60% chance of those storms mainly after midnight tonight. That flash flood watch continues through Saturday around 1 p.m. Northwest Arkansas, our low temperatures will fall into the low to mid-70s, mid-70s for us in the River Valley, where in the River Valley, I think, we're not going to see as much of that rain tonight. Take a look at it with our in-house model here. As we go throughout the night, the best chance of those storms arriving, you can see after midnight towards about the 3 o'clock in the morning hour on Saturday, that's the first round of storms. As we go throughout the night, new rounds of storms move in. And this is why we've got the flash flooding as being a potential, because we get what's known as training start to take over. And when the training of these storms occurs, you're getting heavy rain over the same areas over and over and over again. So that's a problem or potential problem tonight across mainly northwest Arkansas. Now, we get into Saturday morning, and well, some of these storms could get their way into parts of the River Valley, especially eastern sections of the River Valley, early on Saturday morning. As we go throughout the rest of Saturday, I think a lot of us are going to be dry. We're only going to call it about a 40% chance of those storms redeveloping in the afternoon on Saturday. Now, as you can see, through about noon, 1 p.m. on Saturday, the heaviest rain, clearly, our models are thinking in northwest Arkansas. So in isolated locations around northwest Arkansas, you could see some flash flooding. Of course, if you come across flooded roadways, you need to turn around and stay away from those high waters. Now, tomorrow's forecast in the afternoon, high temperatures right around 89, 90 degrees. We've dropped the high temperatures across northwest Arkansas because of the anticipated extra cloud cover and the morning rain. Good news for a lot of folks, I think. 40% chances of those storms developing again on Saturday afternoon. In the River Valley, high temperatures a little bit warmer. We're not going to see as much of that rain in places like Fort Smith, Muldrow, Spiro, and Poteau. So our temperatures are going to be a little bit warmer on Saturday afternoon in the mid-90s with about a 30 to 40% chance of those storms redeveloping in the afternoon on Saturday. You can see it's going to be a warm, muggy day on our Saturday, and we could see additional thunderstorm activity. If you don't get that rain in the River Valley on Saturday morning, you're going to get another chance Sunday morning. I'll tell you about that and much, much more coming up tonight at 9 on the CW and at 10 on 4029.